Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. This time I want to show you how you can tell Hibernate to map the result of a native SQL query to a POJO. Native queries return a list of object arrays. Most developers implement two nested loops to iterate through the list and the elements of the array. That's okay, but not the only approach. JPA supports SQL result set mappings, which you can use to map the query result. You can see such a mapping definition here. The constructor result annotation defines a constructor call of the book value class. The column result annotations define how the columns of the result shall be mapped to the parameters of the constructor. In this example, Hibernate will perform a constructor call with the value of the title column as the first and the value of the date column as the second parameter. You can provide the name of the SQL result set mapping as the second parameter to the createNativeQuery method. I do that here. Hibernate will then apply the mapping to the query result and return a list of book value objects. You can use this mapping with all results that return at least the parameters defined by the column result annotations. As you can see here, the SQL result set mapping didn't change the SQL statement. Hibernate executes the native query and then applies the mapping to the retrieved result. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!